Hi everyone, welcome back. Let's talk about the basic questions of Node.js. Till now we were just talking about the basic JavaScript questions. So what is Node.js? First of all, that Node.js is single-threaded and highly scalable system that utilizes JavaScript as its scripting language. And Node.js is built on top of V8 runtime environment. I mean, it's like the same what the Chrome browser is using. So on Chrome browser, we are using V8 with the browser environment, but Node.js is, like you can say, built on top of V8 with libraries without the browser environment, okay? So you don't have any document object there or window object there the Chrome browser environment, okay? So the main feature of Node.js is it's a single-threaded, highly scalable, and no IO blocking, and event-driven. Okay, so Node.js is actually a non-IO blocking, and using even using the single-threaded mechanism, it is managing to do the asynchronous task parallelly using event loop and event queue mechanism. So there is a separate event loop running. So I hope you are already familiar with the event loop mechanism in Node.js, that how Node.js is able to run the multiple processes together. You can see the multiple tasks, like there are multiple asynchronous requests coming from the multiple users. It is running them parallel in a single pipeline, but the asynchronous operations is being passed one at a time from the event loop. Okay, so there may be a questions about the NPM, so how to update a package in the dev dependency, in the normal dependency. Okay, how to install a package as a global module. These all these questions. And first of all, why Node.js is a single-threaded? So Node.js is a single-threaded for asynchronous processing. By doing asynchronous processing on a single thread under a typical web loads, more performance and scalability is being achieved by Node.js. And Node.js is actually written on top of C++. Maybe C++ is a multi-threaded, but on top of the layer of JavaScript, because JavaScript, we already know that it's a single-threaded environment. And callback hell, what is a callback hell in Node.js? We already know, and how to prevent and how to fix a callback hell. We can split out the callback functions into the multiple functions and call them one by one instead of doing nesting in all the callbacks. There can be a question about Node REPL. So read, eval, print loop, because Node.js is giving you the CLI environment where you can execute your command. So Node.js, whatever the Node.js applications we are writing, we are actually executing all the applications using node space the file name, node space server.js. Either we are using PMT to manage all these processes. So Node.js is a read, eval, print loop. You are actually entering some command on the command line, and then Node.js is executing that on top of V8 runtime environment. Okay, so it's like you are using the shell prompt of a Node.js. Okay, and you might have heard about Node.js global object, process object. So Node.js has these global objects where you can put the things, like to manage the different environment in the Node.js application, you have the process object. Similarly, there is a global object in Node.js, which you can just see from the Node.js CLI. So this is my terminal, and here if you do the process object, this is the big process object. Similarly, these are the global definitions, which is talking about where you have kept your node modules, a global definition. So a lot of default configurations are there in the process. In the process object, you can add the environment variables like these, the path and all these things. So what is the objective of having npm? So we also have npm and I'm using Node.js as a using Node version manager, which is NVM, where you can switch to the different versions in the Node.js. Okay, so what are the different API framework which you can use? Like you can use Express is a kind of a web framework, also provide you the API implementations. And similarly, you can use a Happy.js, you can use a Koa, and all these things. Okay, so these are the basic questions which can be asked about Node.js.